the serpent had so much intelligence, the enemy has been there from the beginning. And he's been there all along. God is the creator. God is the blessing of everything. God gives us, you know, everything that is good, everything that is wonderful. And the enemy isn't creative like God. He didn't create the world. He's not intelligent, but he is evil, and he's very determined. So what he doesn't have in all the blessings and gifts and power of God, he makes up for in just sheer nastiness and sheer evilness. And he's always been there. And I learned that I had to pay some attention to that even in the hospital, because I had patients who were really compromised because of the demonic. And I found even in the hospitals, if we didn't get rid of that, it was really going to be hard to get people well the way that they wanted to. I have many, many cases, examples of this. One of my favorites was a fellow that I prayed for who was in a kind of a comatose condition, and that he wasn't, you know, real clear or verbal or anything. But the demonic was very strong in him, and this was one man who, like some of the people I cared for, was very violent. And he tried to punch me and bite me and kick me and would lunge at me from his hospital bed. He actually had to tie his arms down, and he was impossible. I'd go in there and, you know, there he'd like fly at me to, like, you know, hurt me. So I prayed over this man, and the devil left, the demonic left him, and he was free. And then he became like a different person. All of a sudden, he could get healed very beautifully from God, very nicely. He was one of my super overweight patients in the hospital, and in a couple weeks, he had dropped over 100 pounds. Now, that is not something we normally see in the medical field. I've seen up to 200-pound weight losses really fast from God. But the man, his behavior changed, he lost all this weight, all of his medical issues cleared up so quickly, and the nurses all said, this is a complete miracle. They said this man's had a miracle healing. And it was very sweet. Before they discharged him, he was crying and sobbing and so grateful for the healing and the kindness and everything. He really choked him up. And so we don't want the enemy in anybody. And everything that I see on these sheets is not from God. God doesn't do these things to anybody. The real war is between the, you know, in the unseen realms, is between the enemy and the forces of evil and the Lord, who is all light and all goodness. And we know what God is. You know, we know from all over the Bible, you know, God is perfect. He is light. He is love. I love the book of John because it always reinforces to me that God is the light. And in him there is no shadows, there's no darkness, he's perfect. So the enemy is there to just keep us from the Lord. There's no other purpose for the enemy. So I like to start the service now just to spend a couple of minutes and just acknowledge that we don't want him here.
That's right.
I'm sure nobody wants him in this room.
That's right.
So I want to acknowledge that he's unwelcome, and that we want to get rid of him, and I'm going to give him off to the Lord. And I'm going to be praying into some various things that I think are crucial. Periodically, God changes some of the variables that he has me praying for just based on, you know, his choice and what he wants. My goal, since as I look through this, there's a tremendous amount of requests on here for all kinds of things. There's cancers on here. There's autoimmune diseases. There are structural issues. There's non-autoimmune inflammatory diseases. There's a lot of emotional things, life things. So I want to make sure that we really address this. This is very important that this gets addressed in the time that I have with you. So a few things. For those of you that have been with me before, you all know that I pray for the brain. That's one of the things that God never, that's why the brain is on the picture that Pastor Cindy did. It's just, medically, it's sort of a non-negotiable because everything is regulated through your brain. There is not one thing on here that is not touched by the brain. So I go into that in terms of things that will be beneficial for every single one of you. When you're talking about the brain, I could go into it in so much detail that we'd be for all night, all into the next day, in such detail. And And what I've really been trained by God to do is pray for you in a way that what I pray for can really work with everybody. And it's very specific, as well as working with all of you at the same time. We have to remember that as the Creator, there's nothing that God can't heal. And He could heal everyone on the earth all at once if He wanted. Just as He created all of us and the earth and everything there is, it's not like God couldn't heal 8 billion people at once. I mean, there's no limit to His power. So He's completely individualizing and focusing on each and every one of us as I pray, yet we're all getting touched by Him at the same time. It's amazing, the work of the Lord. So I want to make sure that I cover these things, but I also am going to be doing some first prayer, since I really want to work at that level of God's miracle creation, is I'm going to do a little bit of prayer into your genetics. And this is very important, and I just want to mention this for a few minutes. I'm going to start right in on praying. Why is this important? Is that when we're all conceived and we're all created, of course that happens at the time that the mother and father come together. And what are we given at that time? We're given, half of us is the genetic material coming from the mother's side of the family, and half of us is the genetic material coming from the father's side. And given the creation of God, everything that God creates is perfect. But we know that from the standpoint of the enemy, that we're given imperfect genetic material. And the transfer at that time and the creation of ourselves as living beings is the closest you can get to the miracle of creation, where you are created by God. Where you literally, you have no brain, you have no beating heart, you have no nothing, you just have yourself as the creation of the Lord as He created you. And given that we have the family generational curses, there's a lot of passed down, some of which is good and some of which isn't so good. So this is something that needs to be cleaned up. And the field of genetics is interesting because it's the closest that we have now to proving that the Bible is real and that there really is God. And there really is an enemy, and we do not want the enemy. The other thing that's interesting about the field of genetics is it's starting to show that a number of things that we never understood in the medical field or that we understand incorrectly in the medical field, we're finding more correct information from understanding the genetic level. It's very interesting research. I'll give you a very quick example before I start to pray over this, which is your mind, which is, as I say, I've never met the perfect person walking into the medical office or the hospitals or the churches. Anybody here perfect tonight? Did one of you come tonight to bless us because you're perfect? Please join me and I will sit down and you heal all of us. But if all of you are not perfect, then you're like everybody else, even though you're going to be wonderful people who have many gifts and many wonderful things to share, which I know you all do, without question. So it's very amazing because we're learning things about how the devil works and how God works when we look at our genetics. That's why it's important to pray over, because God can correct anything, including what happened with His miracle creation of you at the time you were coming into being. So when I say that, let's just go over a few statistics. Do you all know how many cells you have in your body? 37.2 trillion. It's a lot of cells. So just think of how much work God has to do to code for all of this in your chromosomes and your genes and your DNA and RNA. 37.2 trillion cells. You all know how many cells you have in your brain, right? Some of you do. Anybody remember that here? You have 100 billion, almost, just slightly less than 100 billion cells in your brain. And on every single, they're neurons, every single one of those cells has 7,000 receptor sites for chemicals like neurotransmitters to bind. So you're looking at 37.2 trillion cells that make up one little person. And you have 100 billion cells in your brain and nervous system with each neuron having 7,000 receptor sites for these kinds of chemicals to bond. We're talking trillions of reactions going on in you all the time. With billions of us, that is how amazing God is, that he could put this all together. It's totally incredible. Now, in the medical field, without knowing a lot about genetics, we've been going more on looking at these chemicals. And so if we look at mental illness, which basically everybody has, and I don't mean you're mentally ill, like you got to go to a psychiatrist and be put on drugs, but we all have less than 24/7 perfect love of God within us. There's a lot of really nice people out there, but none of us are completely perfect and impervious to ever being bothered or upset or being depressed or anxious or angry or fretful or fearful or worried or abandoned or rejected or whatever it's going to be. It's an infinite number. And the enemy loves to bother us with these things because, it's a way he can make our physical health worse. So everybody's got some level of this when we really shouldn't have any of it. We really should have nothing. So we've looked at it as chemical issues medically. And when we look at it that way and you go to your doctor, at least many millions of people do, not everybody, but millions do, and you're going to say, I don't feel so good. I feel kind of depressed. I'm having more panic, more anxiety. I haven't been sleeping as well. I'm upset. Things are on my mind. And what do we do with you? You guys know what we do. We give you antidepressant drugs. We give you anti-anxiety medication. You know, we try to get your serotonin up. You know, some of you have been through this. There are millions of people that never go to the doctor for this kind of thing, but they still get off. They still don't feel as good as they should. And how we relate to it in the medical field is every one of these illnesses, there are over 200 mental illnesses that have been identified in my field, and about 10 or 12 of them are the main ones millions of people affected. And of course, those are depression and anxiety and OCD and bipolar and autism and schizophrenia and psychosis and PTSD. I mean, untold millions of people just in our country. So we give you very specific medication. Now, what have we found in the field of genetics about this? We're starting to test many different diseases simultaneously. Like we're looking at depression along with bipolar, along with autism, along with schizophrenia, along with ADHD. And what would we expect to find? Like all kinds of very big differences. And what we're finding is something different. We're finding when the enemy at the time of creation went through you, he just ripped your genetic material to pieces. And what we're seeing is a lot of similar mutations that are identical. Doesn't matter if you're schizophrenic or depressed. Just an example.